Morning students, now this is the continuation of our last video only in which we had discussed regarding the classification of bases. So continuing with that only, now we are going to discuss classification of bases on the basis of their acidity. Now what is the meaning of this term acidity? Actually acidity of a base, that mainly what is the number of hydroxyl ion get produced by one molecule of the base in the aqueous solution, or you can say the number of hydrogen ion with which a molecule of that base will react to produce salt and water only, that is known as acidity of the base. So this can be again of three category: monoacidic, diacidic and triacidic. Monoacidic bases, for example NaOH or KOH, where there is presence of one OH ion. So monoacidic bases means the bases which dissociates in either in their molten state or in aqueous solution to produce only one hydroxyl ion per molecule of that base. For example NaOH, when we taking this NaOH aqueous form, we will get one OH ion. At the same time, when you will take KOH, NH4OH, all will provide you the same. Now, second is dibasic. Diacidic. As it is clear from the name, di means two. Means when diacidic base. For example, students, like NZOH whole twice. CaOH whole twice, and more you can take here, FeOH whole twice, PbOH whole twice, ZnOH whole twice, here it is KOH, NH4OH once. Okay, so all these you can observe here, in all these cases number of hydroxyl ion is 2. So the base which dissociates in molten state or in aqueous solution to produce 2 hydroxyl ion per molecule of that base, then they are considered as dibasic base. Dibasic base, just look at here. In this case, we will get 2OH minus and NZ plus. Okay. Now the third category is tribasic. Again clear from the name, tri means three hydroxyl group. So the base which either in their molten state or in aqueous form furnishes three hydroxyl ions, they are known as triacidic. Example will be what, students? Three hydroxyl ions they have to furnish: AlOH whole 3, FeOH whole 3. And you can take more examples where you will get 3 hydroxyl ion like aluminium hydroxide. When you will take their aqueous form, you will get here 3 plus and 3OH minus. So number of hydroxyl ion get produced is 3. So it is triacidic. Now students, we will discuss the preparation of bases. How bases can be prepared? So as we have already discussed, the bases are metallic oxides, hydroxides. So first we are going to see preparation of metallic oxides. How are metallic oxides get formed? By reacting with oxygen, heating with oxygen. So preparation of bases is not very important for you, because in examination this part is not very important from that point of view, but we can see that. So first is from metals. In this case the typical reaction will be metal plus oxygen, metallic oxide, like Mg plus O2, Na plus O2. In return, what we will get here? MgO, Na2O. And these metallic oxides are basic in nature. Number two, by action of, by
action of water on reactive metals. By action of water on reactive metals. Reactive metals, you can understand, in reactivity series, the metals which are placed on top as well as there in that way. So reactive metal is what here? Sodium, potassium, calcium. So when they will react, sodium, potassium and calcium, when we are going to react them with cold water only, with cold water, be getting there NaOH plus H2, KOH plus H2, CaOH whole twice plus H2.
So the typical reaction, you can understand, active metal plus water, base plus hydrogen gas. And the balancing part, as I told you, please take care of the balancing part.
So children, now I think you have understood this reaction also. Now we are going to do the third method. Third method is by the action of water on soluble metallic oxide. This one. By action of water on metallic oxide. Action of water
on metallic oxide. But
metallic oxide must be what? Soluble. Metallic oxide must be soluble, like Na2O, like K2O, Na2O, K2O, we can also take CaO. And when you will add water to them, you will get their hydroxide. So this is also a base, you know that. So NaOH, KOH, CaOH whole twice.
And what about the balancing part?
You can do balancing part.
That is your duty to do the balancing nicely. Now the third we have done. Now the fourth point is by the process of double decomposition. By the process of double decomposition, like what already we did in analytical chapter, metallic salt plus alkali. Metallic salt plus alkali, then we getting their concerned metallic hydroxide plus another salt.
So the fourth method of preparation of bases is double decomposition. Fourth method is by double decomposition. Decomposition method.
By double decomposition method, in this method, the common reaction what we using generally, children, we taking the aqueous solution of salt. So salt solution plus what we using here, base only.
On that base, generally we using alkali. Then what we getting? Another salt plus basic hydroxide. Basic hydroxide
plus another salt, what you going to take there?
Normal salt.
Okay, like salt solution. You take the example of salt solution, copper sulfate or zinc nitrate, and alkali take here NaOH, alkali take here KOH. What you will get in return?
Copper hydroxide. Okay, plus Na2SO4, plus Na2SO4. Here what you will get, children? Zinc hydroxide. Here we will get zinc hydroxide plus the concerned salt is KNO3.
So I think this point is clear to you. Now the next method is by the action of oxygen on metal sulfides.
Action of oxygen on metal sulfides. So take here metal sulfide plus oxygen.
What we will get in return?
Metallic oxide plus SO2 gas. So do this, ZnS, FeS. You can take anyone, plus oxygen. Plus oxygen.
What we will get there?
ZnO plus SO2. what we will get here? FeO plus SO2. Now the balancing part, you check this. 2, 3 and 2, 2. This one also, you just try to balance it. It is balanced or not, you have to take care. Same manner you do.
Now the last is by decomposition of salt.
By decomposition of salt. Decomposition of what kind of salt? Like sodium carbonate, but like calcium carbonate. So when we going to heat, what we getting? Metallic oxide. So that's all regarding the preparation of bases. One two more point if you want, you can go through from your book.
Now students, in next video we will discuss properties of basic. Thank you.